Welcome back, Minties, to Near Mint Condition, a channel where you can be part of a positive, honest community and lay claim to some comic book knowledge. We are the Astonishing Raze, and today we are going to be reviewing King in Black by Donny Cates and Ryan Stegman, so please stay tuned. The finale to the King in Black event has finally arrived, so it's apropos that the Astonishing Melanie and her symbiote Raze enjoy reviewing this book.
Raze here to lend aid.
Thank you to the folks at Marvel and David Gabriel for sending us this review copy. We greatly appreciate it. There shall be a non-spoiler review recounting the events of issue 1, and if you would like to skip spoilers, you will see a timestamp in the description below to the end of the video.
If you'd like to support the channel, please check out our Patreon page, hit like, and subscribe.
Here we have the cover, obviously. Don't know why I even said that. And I love it when flipping to the first page, I'm going to kill your world. That's such a cool, badass way to start it off. Awesome. It cuts off what this whole weapon is here. So nice little preview. Eddie Brock is concerned about his spawn child, Dylan Brock, because the god of the abyss, the symbiote god Null, has arrived. He tucks him away in a nuclear bomb shelter and teams up with the Avengers and X-Men to stop the oncoming symbiote dragon army. I love how the title's right here, King in Black. The latter two fight off waves of attacks while Venom tries to infiltrate Null's hive mind army.
We like this panel here of Venom being a solitary figure about to take on Null on their own.
The stakes are raised when symbiote-covered Celestials lower down from the sky with a crunch.
Sentry takes a stab at incapacitating the god of the void, but he is quickly overwhelmed in a horrifically delicious manner.
And because the light of the stars is annoying, Null envelops the world in a symbiote shell.
That sounds like a new line of candies to us. Crispy, crunchy, yet gooey and sticky symbiote shells coming to a candy store near you.
We like the caricature design of Null with his over-the-top huge mouth. Nice touch.
Venom, who apparently refer to themselves as individuals, I know... Eddie wanted to tell you.
Readies himself to confront Null head on by powering up with swirls in his eyes. Just like the Spiral King and Gurren Lagann, Minties. You guys know what I'm talking about? Yeah, you do. That part's really cool. The power-up pep talk was truly only to amass the strength and courage to confront Null, for he quickly begs him to spare the world since he will go without a fight.
However, Null reveals that he is searching for Dylan Brock and not the weirdly individualistic Eddie Brock.
With that revelation out of the way, the God of the Abyss rips off the poor symbiote and separates the best relationship ever and drops him to the ground below like so much refuse. And we got Peach Momoko.
Spoiler time if you dare.
Spider-Man carries Eddie off while the Human Torch sacrifices himself. He'll probably come back. We appreciate the characterization with Peter Parker trying to help out Dylan and still being humble after all these years, but I feel like he's interrupting the meeting of the true heroes in charge as they create a plan of attack. We've got Namor showing up being all like, let me take a charge, and he's like, what is up with this? And she's like, Sorry I invited him, but we kind of need him. Iron Man is trying to take over with data and science and such the symbiote dragon so he can get a piece of symbiote, put it back on Eddie. But he dies at the end of the issue.
Issue 3 begins with a line that mentions our name. Null has raised his way across the stars. Thumbs up for that.
The heroes have to fight off the other heroes who are merged with symbiotes, and Dylan seizes the chance to join the fray. He gets to perform the first of two classic, this is a cool moment because a hero is using another hero's weapon. We like that. Thor flies down to lend his aid and battle Null, not only with Mjolnir, but also with who can come up with the best way to declare how badass of a god they are. Awesome picture. Look at that. Knocking his jaw off. Dylan appears to join forces with Null, but instead he attempts to free the heroes from the mind hive of the symbiotes. However, this does not slow Null down.
Heroes regroup and launch a counterattack, including Namor, which we wanted to see more of, like his actual battle, instead of standing around and waiting for the command to attack. Perhaps it's in the comics, the tie-in comics, his title, but perusing the internet, we could not find his battle.
Jean Grey pries into the god's mind to see what the heroes can utilize to create his downfall. As she reveals the god of light is the answer, Silver Surfer shows up and Null lets out the coolest no ever. I love that design. And the god of light enters Brock's corpse. Where is it? There it is. The second moment of a hero utilizing other heroes' weapons occurs as Venom combines Mjolnir and the Surfer's boar to make this awesome axe. He states for the first time in a long time, we're having fun. There you go. There's classic Venom. And what a jolly frock it is. But this panel right here messes with us because we were on the right side and then all of a sudden we're on the left and then we go back to the right perspective. Just a little editing note. There's the threat from Null that the darkness lives on in Dylan, but Venom declares with their ultimate attack that this is for their son. We love how the Surfer and the God of Thunder hold a hesitant look in their eyes as they summon back their weapons. Brock disintegrates the last remnants of Null and Dylan and discovers that he is indeed the King in Black of all the symbiotes, complete with a new set of wings. The end. Got this nice timeline reference material thing here, Heirs of the Throne. And as usual, the variant covers. Man, I love the colors on these tattoo variants. And when Eddie falls on the car, oh, that's cute with his eyes like that. Munching away on Iron Man. Oh yeah, reminds me of the Spider-Man Fox cartoon. This Scotty Young variant, let's see.
I can't see what it says. Donnie, I thought you said long arms. Strong, Ryan, I said strong arms. In conclusion, the stakes are high when heroes fall and others are hopeless. But fear not, because the structure of the story is for lots of surprises of like, oh, here comes so-and-so being like extra ultra cool.
We rate this an 8 out of 10 for art and fun.
This can be a standalone read without reading all of the tie-ins. Yeah, there's lots of surprises at every third page turn. I think you guys would like it. Go ahead and pick it up. Thank you so much for watching. Remember, we have a Patreon with multiple tiers to fit your needs.
And as always, stay minty!